Good morning, everybody. Just give me 2 seconds to catch my breath. It's an honor to be here this morning, to be really honest with you. It's kind of a dream come true to be a part of this new partnership and engagement with First Nations communities. From what I've been told, that's going to be all across Canada. My name is José. I'm from Pequawkinagan. My father is Algonquin, and my mother is French-Canadian. I was born in Ottawa. I lived here for 8 years. I moved to Toronto, and I lived there for 17 years. And I found myself back here on Algonquin territory, and it's been a very great decision. One thing I want to share with you is I'd like something for you all to keep in mind. We're in a time of reconciliation. There's a lot of things happening in Ottawa, and it's a great thing. There's an opening of Indigenous artistic halls at the Art Gallery. We have this new Indigenous theater program here at the National Arts Center. And there's Indigenous urban communities that are popping up in a lot of cities, especially here in Ottawa. There's language revitalization. There's education that's being shared. There's new curriculum that is being written. All of this is going to play into the productions that perhaps happen here at the National Arts Center. But one thing that needs to be kept in mind are the systemic traumas that have happened to our people because of residential school, and myself being the daughter of a 60s scoop child. We have a lot of talent. We might not have went to school to study and get a Bachelor of Arts in Dramatic Arts. But that doesn't mean that we are not as equally talented and capable of being a part of this Indigenous theater program. So I'd like to keep one thing in your minds. For those of you that are in the position to make decisions of who you cast and how you engage and how you go forward, that you don't box us out because we don't have that piece of paper. Miigwech. Thank you.
Thank you, José and Yancy. We're so happy that you are here with us this morning. And welcome everyone here and those of you on Facebook Live to the National Arts Center, Canada's home for the performing arts, which is situated on the unceded territory of the Algonquin people. Merci José et Yancy de la Première Nation de Pequawkinagan. Puis nous sommes très heureux que vous soyez avec nous aujourd'hui. Bienvenue au Centre national des arts, carrefour canadien des arts de la scène, situé sur un territoire algonquin non cédé. Bienvenue aussi à ceux qui se joignent à nous sur Facebook Live. We're here this morning, I'm on my tippy toes. It's like, why can't I breathe? We're here this morning to celebrate a new beginning. Nous sommes ici aujourd'hui pour célébrer un nouveau départ. And it's my distinct pleasure to welcome Algonquin elder Annie Smith St. George to open the day with a blessing. Kwikwi. Kwikwi, hello. Sigil. Annie Smith St. George, Kishkonik Patna de Kas, Kediganzi Bionjiba, Makodotum, Nichija, Minwanda Mabak, Kakina Chayawak, Eka Kinur, Ekawan, in Niwag. Wasanjama. Nalangam. I'm very happy to greet you on the land of my people, the Algonquin people, the land of my ancestors as well, who walked these lands. Ça fait plaisir de vous accueillir sur le territoire, le grand territoire
de mes ancêtres et le territoire, le peuple algonquin. It's a big day. It's a nice day. It's a new beginning, a new start. You know, moving forward is so important for the Indigenous people of Canada, walking together. And this is a place where we start to walk. As the artists, it's politically correct to do their art and to say, and they could tell the truth in an artistic way. It is a nice way to communicate and to share our culture, our ways, new legend, our legend, and so forth. But also, it is our way of life. We always start with an opening prayer. And I'd like to have everyone stand. As I light the fire, the sweet grass, that we come together in one mind, one body, and one spirit. Miigwech, Chikjamonido. Thank the Creator for this beautiful day that we have today. Today, at this moment. For the sun that rises. For the moon that glares at night. That influences the waters and influences the women and the women that give birth. The star world. I thank the Creator for that star world that gave our ancestors directions and glared and directed us in the nights. Thank the Creator for the bird world. All the birds throughout the world, Miigwech. The four-legged that gives up their lives so that we could nourish our body, the moose, lizardmew, the chevreuil, the deer, all of those, thank the Creator. Gigonzog, the fish, the poisson, au travers la terre, Miigwech. I thank the Creator for these gifts to the smallest, tiniest insect, the ants, and all the little ones that are working so hard for our gardens. And so that we can have a beautiful garden, so that we could nourish our body, Miigwech. Thank the Creator for us being here today, all in harmony, all in beauty. Each and every one of us is so individual and so beautiful, a gift that the Creator has offered us each day as we rise with the sun. I thank the Creator for that gift, either it's in the gift of the communication, la parole, l'écriture, the one that writes, the one that shares and tells stories, face here with the others. Thank the Creator for this great gift and giving us this energy, giving us the physical, the emotional, the mental, and the spiritual capacity to work together in harmony. I thank the Creator for all these great gifts. As I was given medicines from the West, I acknowledge the elders from each directions that are here today. And the Anishinaabe people that are here today as well, man, lady, and everybody that is here, Kakinawiak, Miigwech, and it is going to be a beautiful day, Miigwech.
Thank you, merci, Miigwech Annie.
On October 5th, 2015, the National Arts Center, under the leadership of Peter Herndorf, met with members of the Indigenous performing arts community to talk about the idea of launching an Indigenous theater, a theater led by Indigenous artists at the NAC. February 13th, 2016, a group of leaders met here on the theater stage to discuss in more depth how this might come to be. In the spring of 2016, the NAC announced in its strategic plan that an Indigenous theater department would open in 2019 and that the first artistic director of Indigenous theater would be named in 2017. Au printemps 2016, le CNA a annoncé dans son plan stratégique l'inauguration d'un département de théâtre autochtone en 2009 et la nomination en 2017 de la toute première personne à assurer la direction artistique. Voici enfin venu le moment tant attendu. Here we are, and it's a thrilling moment for all of us. My name is Sarah Garten-Stanley, and along with everyone in English theater, French theater, the orchestra, dance, presents, the Scenes Festival, and coordinators Brittany Ryan and Leslie Parlane, I've had the distinct privilege of working towards today. Along the path, we've been joined by two artistic advisories. The first, Renelta Arluck, Michael Grey-Eyes, and Margot Kane, got us to February 2016. The second, Renelta Arluck, Dave Janis, Jesse Wabagijic, Kenneth T. Williams, and Elder Annie Smith St. George bring us to now. Beginning in April 2016, we began publishing monthly newsletters to our website, and this year we began a first elders council from across the land. It has been expected by the community, and we have worked hard to achieve transparency throughout. At every step, the NAC was led by the community. The hiring process was developed with the advisory committee, human resources here at the NAC, and the plan was shared widely with the community before we proceeded. The announcement for the position was posted at the beginning of November 2016. In February this year, in an institution-wide initiative, the NAC worked with Algonquin chiefs and community members in the formation of a first Algonquin advisory council, and some of those members are here today. The purpose of this council is for the NAC to develop right relations with the Algonquin people who are the past, present, and future caretakers of this land, and to work together to better reflect the original people of this territory in this building. En cours de route, nous avons créé un comité consultatif algonquin pour tisser des liens solides entre le CNA et la nation algonquine, en qui nous voyons la gardienne du passé, du présent et de l'avenir de ce territoire. Nous voulions que les Algonquins soient représentés comme il se doit au sein de notre organisation. Avant de terminer, je crois qu'il est extrêmement important de mentionner la contribution de tous les artistes autochtones de la scène dont le talent et les efforts nous ont amenés jusqu'ici. Before I conclude, I think it's deeply important to credit every Indigenous performing artist whose artistry, creativity, and sweat has contributed to this moment. And in particular, to honor Spider-Woman Theater, Native Earth Performing Arts, Dabajimajig Storytellers, Andinuk Théâtre, Full Circle Performance, Kagiyovit Nunavut Performance, Gordon Tatusis, ACPIC, Red Diva, Article 11, Urban Inc., Onishka, Chocolate Woman Collective, Urban Indigenous Collective, Signal Theater, Anamataxi, Making Treaty 7, Red Sky, Center for Indigenous Training, and the Indigenous Performing Arts Alliance, all companies making trails for others to follow. Et maintenant, accueillons. Et maintenant, accueillons le visionnaire président et chef de la direction de longue date du Centre national des arts. Please welcome the long-serving and visionary president and CEO of the National Arts Center, Peter Herndorf.
Thank you very much, sir. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to a historic day. Bonjour tout le monde. Je suis très, très fier de vous souhaiter la bienvenue au Centre National des Arts. In 1969, the National Arts Center opened its doors with a resident orchestra and outstanding performances in music, theater, and dance. We were unique because we were national, because we were multidisciplinary, and because we were bilingual. From the very beginning, we presented English and French theater seasons, a reflection of the way Canada defined itself at that time. Over the past decade, Canadians had begun to see themselves in quite different terms. The former artistic director of English theater, Peter Hinton, was an ardent champion of Indigenous theater, ensuring a presence over six successful seasons of productions like Copper Thunderbird, The Ecstasy of Rita Joe, and Night. And I think it's worth mentioning, for those of you who don't have tickets yet, Peter Hinton's production of Riel, the opera, opens tonight at the National Arts Center. It's a stunning piece of work by Peter Hinton, by a exceptional cast. And if you get a chance to see it, it's the opening of the Canada scene. The tradition was continued by English Theatre's artistic director Gillian Kiley and associate artistic director Sarah Garten Stanley, who facilitated important national retreats to explore Indigenous theatre in Canada. And over the past 18 months, all of the program departments at the National Arts Centre brought new and powerful storytelling to our stages in dance, music, and theatre. Stories inspired by the residential school system. The theme was art and reconciliation, and our audiences were deeply moved by the experience. There was Going Home Star by the Royal Winnipeg Ballet. I Lost My Talk, a multimedia creation developed by our music director, Alexander Shelley, and inspired by the poetry of Mi'kmaq poet Rita Joe. Our music education department was reaching out to Rita Joe's community in Eskasoni and to Indigenous communities across the country through our Music Alive program. And our executive producer of the Scenes Festival, Heather Moore, was presenting Indigenous artists from every region of the country. The NAC was awakening, and people began to notice. On the night we presented Going Home Star in January of 2016, Marie Wilson, the former Truth and Reconciliation Commissioner, moderated a panel and said the NAC was keeping its promise of reconciliation. And I'm absolutely delighted that Marie is here. Could I ask her to stand and take a bow? Another speaker that night described the healing power of the arts by saying, "Art is medicine." That's why today is such an important day in the life of the National Arts Center. I'd like to thank the Indigenous Theatre Selection Committee, which has guided us to this moment. Our external members, Montreal's Dave Jeunesse, Laurie Marchand of Kamloops, Jesse Wabagijic of Manitoula Island, Will Grey Eyes from the Managing Director of French Theatre, Debbie Collins, our Director of Human Resources, and Sarah Garten Stanley, the Interim Facilitator of Indigenous Theatre. I wish this day had come much sooner. In fact, I wish when we'd opened our doors in 1969, an Indigenous theater department had been part of the fabric of this institution. But it's not too late, and today we are making one of the most significant steps in our 48-year history by naming the person who will build a critically important new Canadian theater, the Indigenous Theater at the National Arts Center. Please join me in congratulating Vancouver's Kevin Loring, a brilliant actor, playwright, and teacher who is currently gracing our stage with his searing performance in Children of God. And before you give Kevin a big round of applause, I want to say a few more things about Kevin. Kevin has been part of the NAC's family for many years after serving as playwright in residence in 2010, the same year he brought his award-winning play, Where the Blood Mixes, to the NAC. He is also his mother today, and for that, you can't say enough. We are honored to appoint Kevin Loring, our first ever artistic director of Indigenous Theater. Would you give Kevin Loring a boisterous round of applause?
Dumb. Oh, it's a long time coming, eh? Wow. Inyadixtinwenwin, good morning. I'm honored to be here today on the unceded lands of the Algonquin people. Thank you for hosting us. First, I wanted to thank Peter Herndorf and the staff and senior management of the National Arts Center, especially Jillian Kiley and Sarah Stanley for their work over these many years towards this initiative. I want to thank the other candidates for their contribution to our industry, our culture, and our art. There are many trailblazers who've led the charge for many decades in this battle to be heard, to be seen, and to be taken seriously on our stages across this country and across and around the boardrooms where the decisions are made. And on our stages across this country. Without their sacrifices and battle scars, we would not be here today. Kukstjam. I also want to thank my family, my mom who's here today, my partner Jody Kay for her patience, love, and support, for my guests Terry and Christine, who have flown all the way out here from BC to celebrate this day with me on such short notice. Kukstjam. Louis Riel said, "My people will sleep for 100 years, but when they awake, it will be the artists who give them their spirit back." These words from Riel the prophet are true. We are awake, and we are ready to reclaim what is ours. In 1969, when the NAC opened the Studios Theater with the production of The Ecstasy of Rita Joe, it was said that a new age of Canadian theater was born, that Canada had asserted its identity through theater by telling a truly Canadian story. And what was this first truly Canadian story about? Written by George Riga, a settler of Ukrainian heritage, it was a story of a young Indigenous woman and her Indigenous boyfriend caught in the poverty trap of inner-city Canada. Rolling between the judicial system and the bureaucracies that ensnare them until eventually she is raped and they are both murdered at the hands of a group of white men, her body left on the stage in the lap of Canada. This is our seminal Canadian English language play. What does this say about our relationship? What does this say about our history and our legacy of colonialism? 48 years after Rita Joe debuted here at the NAC, I stand here before you in acceptance of the great responsibility of being the first ever artistic director of Indigenous theater at Canada's National Arts Center, the first Indigenous theater department of a national theater anywhere in the world. I'm asked all the time, What is Indigenous theater? Indigenous theater is simply this. They are our stories told and performed through the lens of Indigenous people. We have been telling our traditions in the land. Though we may have, word intentionally, the method of our settler contemporaries, at our stories is the Indigenous perspective, the Indigenous experience, which is inherently different than the settler worldview of this land. Tonight, I will be on stage in Cora Payette's beautiful and powerful play, Children of God, about the residential school experience. Backs, I have said many times that before we can have meaningful reconciliation, we must first have reparation. That the things that were broken must be fixed. I believe that the creation of this new Indigenous theater department at the NAC is a small but important step along the path to reparation. In the 150 years of Confederation, in the 525 years of colonization that Indigenous people have endured, our languages have been brought to the edge of extinction, our dances forbidden, and our ceremonies outlawed. Our traditional songs and stories that remain have survived by going underground. Some Indigenous people went to the extremes of hiding their children. A few special children were hidden so that they could have the language, traditional knowledge, and culture downloaded into them by the remaining knowledge keepers of their people, away from the horrors of the residential schools. I have had the honor and the privilege of working with one such elder. The last time I saw it in Tlikatmuk, Elder Jimmy Tudlikin, he attended a presentation of the Battle of the Birds, a spectacle or creation story about how the bald eagle got their white heads. It's a story about domestic violence that I had adapted into a play with a chorus of Tlikatmuk community members. The first time I heard him orate the story, he did so in our language, Tlikatmukchin. He explained to us our story protocols, that the way in which we tell our stories. After the show, he shook my hand and he said to me that now I am the storyteller for our people, that it was my job now to tell our stories in my own way. I take that as a sacred trust, as I take this position as a sacred trust to the Indigenous storytellers across this land, from coast to coast to coast. It is my hope that the creation of the Indigenous Theater Department here at the NAC will act as a beacon to young artists across the country, that it will inspire them to imagine their stories on our stages. I hope that it will inspire a new generation of Indigenous designers to help realize our visions, administrators to keep us on track and on budget, Indigenous stage managers to maintain the container for our art to flourish and to keep us on time. An Indigenous theater department at the NAC is meaningless without our storytellers. We need you. I am here to support your work. I'm here to make the circle strong. It's my job to help raise you up as best I can. I will fight for your place on our stages and support your voice in the chorus of this country, even when you are screaming at it to stop. Even when you are reminding it of its crimes. Even when you interrogate its very existence and celebrate yours. Our stories are medicine. They can help to heal the wounds history leaves on us, so that we can all truly move forward in a good way. Our work as Indigenous artists often challenges the assumptions of Canada. This challenge we offer is healthy, necessary. It is a declaration and a celebration of our continued existence as peoples, nations, and distinct cultures. We are the land. We are still here, and we are awake. Gokstep, all my relations. Thank you.
We have a few people who have traveled an awfully long way who, both metaphorically and truly, who would like to share some of their celebratory thoughts about Kevin. So I'd ask Terry, Elder Terry Alec, if you'd like to begin.
Yerikson run one snook nookas. And Jowatin squash in kiapa shmua. And then and slick up mach nation, slick up jean, and quake. What an honor to be still awake. Congratulations, my little Shinji, my little brother. What an honor to witness a very big step in Canadian history in the National Arts Center. Wow, I'm shaking like a wet leaf on a springborn day. I watched Kevin grow up as a young warrior in our nation, and through trials and tribulations, he grew like a eagle ready to soar before he even graduated high school, and done some awesome work in our community in Vancouver and wherever he's traveled. And wow, to be here to witness this even bigger step, it tops everything that I've seen you do. And I'm looking forward to seeing Children of God tonight. It's about the residential school issue. I'm a survivor of the residential school. It was I disclosed in 1987 and started my journey in dealing with this issue for 30 years. And I stand before you as a wounded warrior that's still standing and died and came back, and I'm still here. And when Kevin messaged me late Sunday night, he says, Coyote, really would like to see you here. And that's an honor to see Marie again. Wow. Blessings to you. 2 years ago, we came here for the last truth and reconciliation process. And at the time, we were traveling to two hereditary chiefs in Bella Coola. And we actually got a tour of the Parliament buildings here. And we're packing our drums around, and finally we finished the tour, and the one chief says, Coyote, you've been packing your drums around all day and we haven't heard you sing yet. What's up with that? Shaking in my boots, and I was like, this is from royalty, so okay. So this is a royal day. And the song that we sang at the time, Chief Gary Feschuk from Seashell Nation and Joanne from Kamloops Band were in Parliament buildings at the time, and we were standing out in front of the Parliament buildings where they have that fire burning. And so we decided to sing, I call it the winning song. And this is a very appropriate time to bring the song back to Ottawa. I was like, okay, let's do this right then. Let's do this in a celebratory way. And wow, I'm so touched by getting invited to witness my little brother take his big steps and grow beyond our wildest dreams and much more to come. I love you and I wish you the best. And here we go. Stand. Thank you. Many blessings to you throughout this day, and I'm just a young elder in training, actually. So thank you for the honors. It's been quite the walk these 30 years, and to come this far to see my little brother grow beyond my wildest dreams. I'm really honored to be here to witness and to sharing his journey, and what an honor to see his mom again. We haven't seen Lytton residents for years, and we had to come to Ottawa to do that. So, yay! So if I forgot anything in any way, once again, we thank you for the Algonquin Nation for allowing us to be here, and other nations that are here. Much love to you, and I wish you the best on this journey. It's a very powerful journey, and wow. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Terry and Christine, for your beautiful words and for the song. There's a few people who want to say some brief remarks on behalf of Kevin, and so I'd just like to ask Corey Payette if you want to come up and say a few words.
Anin. My name is Corey Payette. My father is from the Matagami First Nations. I acknowledge the Algonquin Nation for allowing us to be here today and on this amazing day. I just wanted to share a few words and congratulations for Kevin. Sorry, I can't look at you or I'm going to start to cry. So Kevin and I started working together 7 years ago at the Vancouver Playhouse. And when he started working with me, there was a level of rigor that he brought to my work and an expectation that he brought for me as a young artist that I carried with me all through these years. And I think it's what has made this work better. It's not that it's about me. It's about that these are stories that have been silenced. These are histories that have never been spoken. And so it's necessary that we be excellent and that we get it right. And so that was what he has instilled in me all these years. And so it has informed all of my artistic practice. It has informed how I want to leave a mark on this world. And I'm so excited for the National Arts Center and this institution that they have decided to bring forward Indigenous theater, but not just for Indigenous people. This is about who we are as Canadians. If you live in this country, this is your theater. You need to know what land you are on. You need to know what Indigenous territory your house is on. And then you need to figure out what your role is in terms of this reconciliation process. So this is a wonderful way to start. I thank Peter Herndorf, Sarah Garten-Stanley, and congratulate the amazing Kevin Loring. Mguetch.
Everyone, this is Kim Harvey.
Oh my God. Kevin and I met before we did his tour, his national tour of Where the Blood Mixes, and I was a kid, I would say. And for me, I think one of the reasons why I'm elated to hear that it's you, Kevin, is for me, every time I've been able to work with you, you have given opportunity. You create the space for opportunities to exist. You demand that same rigor that Corey was talking about. You are a deliberate leader. You are challenging, and you expect so much of us, and you create the opportunity to get it from us. I lovingly call him my mean older brother. Because he pushes me, and he pushes me, and I cannot wait for the entire country of Canada and for each and every nation within this nation to have access to you. Because as a young woman, I feel so empowered by the work that you do and the belief that you instilled in me. We talked the other night about how this is not an easy industry to make it in. Those challenges are even greater as an Indigenous person. And Kevin talked to me about how this has to be a calling. And Kevin Loring, this is absolutely your calling. Said Chananya and Limalin, and our people are cheering for you. Thank you.
I'd love to ask Kenneth T. Williams to come up and say a few words.
Thank you very much. As Mr. Horndorf said earlier, it's about time. It's about time this has happened. I was on the second advisory council, and we understood the importance of what we were doing. We understood the necessity for what we were doing, and we had a lot of joy and excitement about it. But at the same time, we knew, because of the vast amount of talent we have in the Indigenous theater community, we also understand the history of this country's institutions towards Indigenous people. So as we were gathered together by the National Arts Center, we wanted to create a space where someone would want to take the job. And I think we've succeeded, because they have chosen someone who I admire quite a bit, and is someone who I've seen work. We've never had the chance to work together yet, but it's someone who I know and I have full confidence in leading this institution for the first time. And I just want to also point out to the rest of Canada, if you want to talk about reconciliation and engagement, you got to start engaging us as leaders as well. We are here to make We are here to give you our resilience, our survival, our strength from 15,000 plus years of being on this land. And it's not just dirt to us, it's not just rocks. These are our bones that we're talking about. So if you want to feel what it means to be strong, then you have to open up for us, because otherwise we're not going to share it with you in any other way, and we're going to sit there and just do it ourselves. So Kevin, from my ancestors to yours, we got your back.
Jenny Lozon, thank you.
Yes, I'm on my tippy toes too. I'd like to take a very quick moment just to thank all of the other candidates who put their names forward. It means to me that there are many in our communities who are willing to take that challenge and to understand the importance of this position and the work. And so I would ask you all to give them a quick round of applause also for their willingness to come forward. Thank you. So what will be inherent in Kevin Loring's programming choices is integrity. One of the things that I know that Kevin understands is the importance of supporting both emerging and established artists who work in a number of different artistic genres. That's an important distinction for me in terms of what I know that Kevin will bring to this job. However, as been said before, he will challenge us. He'll challenge us to strive for excellence. And so my call out to all Indigenous artists is, let's be the best that we can be so that we can support Kevin in his position here. Let's be the best artists that we can be. Let's make sure that we are very good at what we do so that his job is easier. I know that he will have and represent the hearts of our nations to bring about effective and positive change, not only within the National Arts Centre, but also within the national mainstream industry in Canada. And through Kevin and our support of him, because that's important, we need to support Kevin now in this, because it's going to be a tough job. What we will be able to do with Kevin is show the world just how brilliant we are. Thank you, Kevin. Congratulations.
Et puis en dernier, j'invite Robert Gagné pour dire des mots. Merci, Robert.
Kwekwe, bonjour. J'ai eu le grand privilège de participer au comité de sélection de la direction artistique et d'aller à la rencontre des candidats finalistes au poste. Through this process, I've had the great privilege of meeting exceptional candidates. The finalists have even accepted to open their doors and their hearts in their own communities. And for this, myself and the whole committee, and certainly the NAC, we are extremely grateful. Kevin, c'est au nom de Brigitte Anquin et de toute l'équipe du Théâtre français que je te souhaite la bienvenue au CNA. Le CNA est un endroit paradoxal, avec à la fois un certain nombre de contraintes qui viennent avec toute institution d'envergure nationale, mais aussi, c'est un lieu d'une incroyable liberté. Brigitte has said it on many occasions, what she appreciates the most about being French Theatre's artistic director is the incredible freedom that she enjoys as an artist, as an artistic director. C'est ce que nous te souhaitons pour toi et ce nouveau théâtre autochtone, que ce soit un espace de grande liberté. May you be in a space that allows you tremendous freedom to create, to invent, to be, and certainly to dream Indigenous theater. Brigitte and the whole French theater team joins me in offering you a very sincere and heartfelt welcome. Miigwech. Merci.
Thank you, everyone, for sharing those words and thoughts. And I have two messages to relay from two people who were not able to be here, but whose work and passion about today are enormous. First, Renalta Arluck, the newly appointed Director of Indigenous Arts at the Banff Centre. She says, "Congratulations, Kevin. The multi-skilled experience you bring to the National Arts Centre connects artistry with community, with vision. As the first artistic director of the Indigenous Theatre Department, your leadership to strengthen the voice of Indigenous theatre in this country will echo far. It's an exciting time. Go big. We're here to support you." Wow. And finally, Jillian Kiley, the artistic director of English Theater, who couldn't make her flight last night, and so is probably watching and is here with us, not just in spirit, but probably just glommed onto the, her eyeballs are probably on the screen right now of the computer. Kevin has served the stages of Canada for years as a writer, a performer, a director, and artistic director. Now he'll harness all of those talents and his great gifts as a leader and collaborator to make the stages of the NAC better. How lucky we are. How lucky I feel to be able to be here, standing next to you, in between two great leaders of this world, Peter Herndorf, whose vision has brought us to now, Kevin Loring, who's accepted this extraordinary challenge and will do such amazing things. Merci à tous d'avoir pris part à cet événement spécial avec nous. J'espère que vous resterez des notes pour prendre un rafraîchissement. Thank you all for coming and for sharing in this. We hope you will join us for refreshments following. A special thank you to Terry and Christine for your long journey, and to Elder Annie Smith St. George for opening, and to the Algonquin people for hosting us on this unceded territory. Thank you. Let's drink coffee.